The battle starts now. Well, now, the power comes out immediately from Hugo Calderano, and with the racket high, Simone Gauzy gives it right back and then brings out the power of his own. We are looking at some very quick points, just in terms of the power and the speed. The rally's longer than average. Now, you might think this goes without saying for professional athletes, but table tennis is a very equalizing sport. Physical fitness, obviously, a major advantage. But Simone Gauzy, you'll have a chance to see the leg muscles on him. He gets so much power behind his shots. Works really hard, and again, it's the spin, too. So not a point dropped yet for the French showman, Simone Gauzy. Curse to the commentator, Hugo Calderano gets himself one to crack down on. Simone Gauzy is going to be very decisive about when he chooses to open and how he allows Hugo to open. What an angle here. Bend on this ball. Little acknowledgement of fortune. Watch one more time to see what it's all about. Good serve. Pop it up. It's the edge of the table, that's why. Changes the trajectory. Had it come down clean on top, rally could have continued. You gotta love that sweet sound, the pop of the backhand when it comes off Calderano there. Spin comes in low, relatively shallow. Calderano not bothered. So quickly tied up. 4 points for Simone Gauzy to start. Looking like a runaway, and then Hugo Calderano the next four. Now Hugo Calderano in 2023 has had an outstanding year. Even midway through last year, really.
Five, four.
And in that lobbing game, when he gets back there, he's going to have to try to keep it baseline, keep Hugo Calderano away from the net. I think Tunisia is where Hugo Calderano really got his groove back last year.
Four, six.
Nice length on the table from Hugo Calderano. Keeps Simone Gauzy off the attack. Makes it uncomfortable. Much needed point after six in a row for the thrill from Brazil. Simone Gauzy with the soft hands. Leaves it to the forehand side first and sets himself up with a backhand attack.
Seven, five.
Quite interesting to see teammates and practice partners play against each other. I feel like we see longer rallies on average, partially because they can't trick each other as much in the serve game. Serve is so important. It's a game changer for a lot of players. But both of these players know each other's game quite well. Backhand counter sails just long from Gauzy, and it's Hugo Calderano with a 3-point lead.
Five, nine.
And what a change of events. 9 of the last 10 points for Hugo Calderano, and also 7 of the last 8. Nice placement on this one. Good misdirection from Simone Gauzy. Fairly empty serve.
9-7.
By empty, if you're newer to table tennis, I mean less rotation. Spin is such a big factor. These players can hit a ball that's so spinny that it'd go flying into the bleachers if a non-competitive player touched it. But sometimes taking the spin off gets him a better third ball to attack. What an unusual rally. Neither player, again, it was a bit of chicken, if you will. Both players playing very safe. Spinning softly, not going for the big powerful shot. playing for position and waiting for the right moment. Big shot here as Hugo Calderano keeps it deep to that backhand corner. It is two game points at the third towel break for the thrill from Brazil. Takes his chances, gets low. Leaves Simon Gauzy with a lot to cover there. And once again, deep to the backhand. It's Hugo Calderano who takes game number one. Picking your battles, this is a life lesson, but table tennis also.
Love one.
Right, what's worth fighting for and what are the fights worth picking? Backhand to backhand, Simon Gauzy has an outstanding backhand, but Calderano, you could argue, would win that fight most of the time.
One,
it's going to be a question of shot selection and how to set it up. Good serve there from Simon Gauzy to level the playing field, at least here in game two. It's just amazing. How many times have we seen this power come right back? How quickly they recover. The ball got bigger, less spinny. The players got stronger.
1-3. Two, three.
Or some might say more aggressive. The fire pad that we see out here, I mean, Simon Gauzy snapping that backhand both sides. It's rare to see finesse players. That's part of the reason it's so interesting to watch, say, a Truls Morgaard or an Alexis Lebrun. Players that just really slow down the ball and then can explode when they want, but play some unusual shots. And this is a bit more about the spin. Both players not going for the kill shot. It's guided up by Hugo Calderano until he earns that big opening backhand. He drives the opponent behind the table, and from back there, it's going to be much tougher for Simon Gauzy to win the points. Little break off the top of the net for Gauzy on that opening attack. But scoreboard leveled once again.
Four, five.
Good placement in here. Calderano catches him on the crossover. Right in between the forehand and backhand side.
Six, four.
Very interesting to see. Again, table tennis fans, some have been watching for decades. You wouldn't have to be watching that long to have seen Simon Gauzy's real rise into the top 10. Nor Hugo Calderano, for that matter. Both players relatively young.
Seven, four.
Just 2 years between them, really. Calderano, 26. Simon Gauzy, 28 years old. Got a bit of a table tennis family. In the sense that his partner, we became a father with, works in his table tennis club.
5-7.
Quick towel off here at the second towel break. It's so interesting to think about the players. I think we watch and we admire their skills. Anyone who plays table tennis competitively wishes they could do what these guys can.
5-8.
It would be a dream. But at the end of the day, they come home and they have families to feed, lives to live. Just like everyone else, same concerns. But when it comes to work, it's the moments like these that they train for. How to stay focused, how to find answers, how to adapt to a player who's shutting down your game plan. The ones that people love to see, the crowd absolutely appreciating this, just roaring as this point gets more and more intense. Heavy topspins on the counter, forehands out of position, but the backhand rip on the run too. Training partners just tuning it up and turning it up to the next level out here, and it's just for a 3-point lead for the Thrill from Brazil. So interesting to see how friends so close. I mean, we've seen family members playing for national titles in France in the final recently.
Which
makes me want to look back at the draw here. We've got brothers in the top 32. Beautiful counter. Not easy to do with Hugo Calderano putting that much spin on the ball from down here at this camera angle. Watch that side spin. Calderano brings side back. I mean, from the moment Simon Gauzy introduced side spin, every shot after that continued the trend. Calderano reads the brushing backhand, and once again, he's got two game points. Just like in the first, Gauzy with the long serve, plays it right at baseline, side and topspin, but mostly side. Actually, I said top, I don't know why. It was almost completely side spin, that brushing backhand. Calderano with the serves on his side to secure game two. And he does. 11-8 once again. Deja vu in terms of scoreboard for Simon Gauzy, down 0-2 against his teammate and practice partner. And a bit of fortune, a little gift here from Hugo Calderano to start off game three. Nice change of pace. Again, less spin on this last one. Simon Gauzy just guiding back a little bit flatter with the backhand to the backhand side. Checking the lights before his toss. Interesting. Very similar stroke. Nothing too big to start. Says, I'll let you take the first one. I want to catch you on your recovery. Now this will be interesting. I think the slightly more passive play from Simon Gauzy, you can see him getting backed up really quickly. Not the type of positioning he would want to have to deal with too much. Better than most behind the table, Simon Gauzy, but Hugo Calderano, again, world number five, just gives him that much more time to control the point. So this is nice. Taking the initiative here, Simon Gauzy goes to the wide forehand with the backhand opening. Banana flick, but mostly topspin on it. Cracking backhand as Calderano steps into the lead. Touch game. I thought Gauzy was in trouble after that net ball. Take another look here. Net there. Calderano with the full swing forehand, but good control here from Simon Gauzy to touch it softly, leave it inside the table. Good pressure into the middle. Again, these players hugging the net here in the short rally. Sometimes it's not clear what it is they're acknowledging, raising their hand for.
Go! 6-5.
Could be anything from the edge of the racket to raise the net. Something just not going exactly as planned, but working to their advantage. Nice pressure here from Simon Gauzy. Right into the middle, and a 2-point lead here. Still a little bit more than halfway through the game, but a long way to go to finish successfully here for the French showman. Love that after motion. He contacts the ball, and instead of following through with the same exact motion, he twists and turns the hand just a little bit to keep it deceptive and confusing to read.
6-7.
But a tight serve here, specific, as Calderano leaves it uncomfortably at the baseline, half long. I feel like there have been fewer points without apologies than points with so far in this game. It's been a gritty game.
Go, come on.
And a big forehand from a step behind the table. Just 2 points away here, Simon Gauzy. He sets up 4 game points. Simon Gauzy serves with Calderano. Rocket backhand does it, 11-6, and Simon Gauzy takes the game. Steps and strides in the right direction to create the show we get to watch today. 1-2, Simon Gauzy with the momentum. Not love table tennis after watching a rally like this. The hooks and the curves here, the crowd is nearly applauding throughout. It just got better and better when you thought it was finally enough to win it. An inside-out forehand, ripping backhand, hooking shot. This is 5 highlights in 1 point. Hand to the ground, finally a victor. And just a little wince, acknowledgement that the point is over. No celebration. Calderano takes the first point. These rallies and the explosive parallel backhand to finish. I don't think I'm alone in saying I'm still replaying the first point in my mind. To pull off any one of those shots, only few in the world could do. But to do them back to back against each other as they just got tougher and tougher. Oh man, the French showman is not a misnomer, a name with a whole lot of meaning behind it. And the proof is in the pudding out here right now. Simon Gauzy from way back near the barriers sky lobs it. Look at this, off balance for a moment, jumping, hooking shot. This one nearly touches the screen in the stadium, and this one just too much kick on it. Calderano with a bit of frustration, as you could understand, still a 1-point lead. Remember, this is the player who won the last game. You might think exhibition by the way he played the last few points, but it is far from an exhibition. Everything on the line. 15 points becomes 90 points. I'm talking about world ranking points. Remember, $800,000 these two are playing for. $35,000 to the winner of the men's singles event. After dipping to 35 in the world, Simon Gauzy would love to get some points here. I mean, think about the context. He's got 2 brothers, not his brothers, but Alexis and Felix, or Felix Lebrun, rather, the 2 leading players right now for France. He's making his case for Paris 2024. Only 2 men can represent France at the Olympic Games. In the singles event, 12 of the last 16 points for Simon Gauzy. Talk about change in momentum. Well, now.
No, come on. 2-5.
It's been some time since a change. Remember, that stat was 16 points of the last 16, and he continues. Remember, this is also a player with a 4-2 record against Hugo Calderano.
Come on.
Look at the deception here. Cox back the wrist and waits patiently to see which way Hugo Calderano would lean, if at all. And as he starts to move to the backhand corner, Simon Gauzy goes the other way. This is peripheral vision, patience, and precision. P cubed. A bit of extra power on this one. Calderano with the first point in a long time. Much needed point here to add pressure on his opponent. Hugo Calderano still leading in games.
That saves three.
Defense again from Simon Gauzy, but it was the last hope, basically, a last resort just to get the racket on the ball. Hugo Calderano follows it up right near the net for the put away. A little bit shallow. Calderano flat hitting that. Very difficult to do, but on a ball that high, when you're world number five, he'll have the confidence to do it. 2 points between them now. And a timeout now on Simon Gauzy's side. So the momentum back with Calderano recently. Second serve here for the thrill from Brazil.
Yo, come on.
Big backhand to open. The pressure on the receive. Is it out of the comfort zone? Well, sometimes it has to be. In the back of the table, just inside. Keeps his positioning well, Simon Gauzy. To find the middle of your opponent, to hit it into the body like that when they're that far away. Smart play on the run, Calderano. Big point here, remember, fight for survival, looking to take this to the decider. Simon Gauzy was down 0-2. Good touch here from Hugo Calderano in near the net, keeping it tight. Remember, each player has a timeout. Hugo Calderano, if he needs it, still has it. Simon Gauzy just spent his recently, so he's all on his own now.
That, 7-8.
Smart play, Simon Gauzy resists the attack. Really crucial, watch this, high toss as usual, pendulum serve, plays it soft and gets Hugo Calderano to move way in. A long way to go from that backhand corner, clever play in the push. Smart spin, Simon Gauzy, two shots there, more into the spin, secure. Here's one, heavy spin, and another one, I think it clipped. Yeah, clipped the top of the net there to stay shallow. The finger of acknowledgement there sets up 3 game points for Simon Gauzy. Well, the crowd will love to see more of this. The French showman survives games 3 and 4. To be that aggressive and that confident from that far behind the table. Does he want to be there? No. Is he going to win points from there from time to time? But the odds are going to be much more in Simon Gauzy's favor when he's closer to the table. So Calderano with some satisfaction after the first point. A whole lot of spin. Before the match started, you might recall that one of the key differences that I highlighted between these two is that Simon Gauzy plays an incredibly spinny game. It's been measured, some different AI and different technology. Lead service, he'll play it again.
That one, four.
Calderano quickly recognizing. Hitting it back down into the table. The brushing backhand hasn't bothered Hugo Calderano too much. I can't recall the last time it actually won Simon Gauzy a point. So looking for the short side of the table there, Simon Gauzy going all in on this step around. Hits the net clamp. Interestingly enough, if it does pop up and come down on the opponent's side of the table, the net clamp is considered part of the net assembly, much like the cameras attached to it, actually.
3-2.
Remember, this is it. Only one can move on from here to the round of 16. Touch just creepy crawling over the net. Cribbity creepy crawling, and it's 3 points apiece now. The touch game. Calderanos doesn't miss by a lot either. Hits the top of the net but stays on his side. Keeping it tight. And once again, wow, Simon Gauzy hamstring. Groin, I hope you are okay. The rallies that the crowd loves. Leaping and lunging. Shiny shoes, though. Looking cool. Again, I can't stress enough, as close as these two are as friends, they could both really use the points right now. Prize money, that's great. The eyes there, the bulge as he just lets out a bit of stress, a look of brief relief. Whoever wins this next point will have the momentum coming into the switching of sides. And just too long here, it is Hugo Calderano who will switch sides with the momentum. Serve really sets it up for Hugo Calderano. Simon Gauzy looking for his opportunity to attack, but by the time he played the push, wasn't much he could do there. They are. Look at those. Iridescent. Shoes of dreams. I've got a few on the way. Just like that, actually. 5 serving 4. Hugo Calderano here. And pressure over the table. That forehand drive. Hey, surprise there, little guy. Clever play from Calderano. Push looked like it was going to come long. Seemed like the natural thing Hugo would do was spin it. So Simon Gauzy had backed off the table.
Come on, four.
5-6.
Timing like everything else. Playing a push can sometimes be the right choice, especially if the opponent's backing off the table or expecting an attack. Surprise factor, high priority. Ooh, doesn't miss by much, but it's the difference here. Of 6-all and 7-5, Hugo Calderano. Take a look, high toss serve. You can understand the disappointment because he wasn't going for a crazy shot. It was a fairly secure spin shot, just to the depths of the table. The seatbelt shot across the chest here. Hugo Calderano making a quick decision to keep the forehand in play from the deep backhand corner. Not an easy ball to play. Straight topspin, the most secure. Has the highest arc and the best trajectory for coming down.
That. 8-5.
Good patient play there. Both players waiting to make sure it was called before stopping the point. That Calderano backhand, the rocket coming out. Simon Gauzy knows the weaponry on the other side. It was 4-4. 6 of the last 8 have gone to Hugo Calderano. He's earned this position.
6-9.
Table tennis, such a mental game. No timeout called, not yet. Not from Hugo Calderano. Should there be one more here, we'll see.
Straight.
Now that is fascinating. The brushing backhand. And he comes back with a ripping shot. Simon Gauzy, Calderano, holding his ground near the back of the table. This ball Simon Gauzy has made time and time again. He's made some tougher shots. Again, we've seen a few players out here looking down different levels of humidity, heat, playing all around the world. It is four match points for Hugo Calderano, but not yet. Simone smokes it back down the line, sends it with just trails of smoke behind. Rocket backhand and the pattern turn. Simon Gauzy knows it and knows it well. One match point saved, three more to go for the thrill from Brazil. Ugo, homeboy, it is Ugo Calderano, 3-2 to take it in the decider after the last two games were taken off him. So a good handshake and a pat on the back for teammate, close friend, and practice partner.